Hi, my name is Martin Boyer. I'm with Austin Boats and Motors in Austin, Texas, out by Lake Travis. And I'm going to take you through a new arrival 2015 Glastron GT205. This is a boat that we're pretty excited about for 2015. They've redesigned the exterior and added some interior options that we've been able to take advantage of here, and I think you'll be very impressed with the styling of the boat. The performance has never been a question with Glastron. Of course, they're built on a well-known super stable SSV hull design, which is known for handling rough water, thanks in part to its really nice steep angle of entry in the front. It carries that angle of entry to the back quite well, and just makes for a great riding boat in rough water. It also has a unique strake design on the outside, where you'll see that outside chine kind of starts to fold back over. And as it folds back over, that helps the boat to be able to run at slower speeds and still stay on plane and keep the bow down. And what's really nice about that feature is if you want to pull kids on a tube, you can pull a kid on a tube in that 12, 13, 14, 15 mile an hour speed, where most boats would fall off plane and the bow would actually begin to rise drastically on you and create line of sight issues for the driver from the driving position. With the super stable V-hull design, we don't experience that problem because Glastron's done a good job engineering the outside chine to roll over. And so instead of that continuing to go up at an angle, it actually comes and rolls down. And then that helps push water down and keep the hull more buoyant and better displaced. So that's a really nice feature if you're a dad or a mom looking to support family activities with the kiddos, and tubing is one of those activities. This is a great thing to consider because the competition has many issues with the bow of the boat rising up as you start to decelerate. And so at Glastron, we can keep that bow down and so we can see over the horizon better. So there's a lot of safety, a lot of peace of mind involved in that. And that's a really important feature I like to point out about Glastron. With the exterior styling this year, we've just really come full circle with this boat. This is a new navy. It's a deep navy color. Very attractive. So it's a sophisticated, classy color. It's gonna sell well. It's also gonna resell well. It's not a love me, hate me color like a red or a yellow or a purple or a dark green. So it's just a classic, timeless color. It looks very, very nice with the chrome accents on the rub rail there, and the emblem, the GT205 emblem, the snap heads in stainless steel, the pull-out cleats and polished stainless steel, even the stainless steel clips on the bimini top. It just really ties in real nicely with the boat. You have the stainless steel roller guard up front, and so that really helps to keep the boat from being marred up by this plastic roller in the hot Texas sun as you put the boat back on. So that's a really nice touch that you get with the XL pack, which this boat is actually equipped with. You'll see you have the chrome horn cover, pull up bow cleat in the front. Really excited to show you the interior. One of the biggest changes this year is in the interior. We have some interior choices we didn't have for 2014. This one you'll see is shown in a brand new, what looks like leather appointment. And this particular product here that we're looking at is called cashmere. And cashmere is a kind of a light camel color, kind of what you're used to seeing in the new SUVs, the Lexus and the Escalades, if you will. Very attractive. It's gonna be light to the touch in the sun. It's gonna hide stains well. Really gives the boat a really elegant look. You'll notice here on the floor also we have something new, and that's seagrass. That's actually a woven mat that's built by a company specifically for nautical applications like this. It's got an expanded rubber back on the back side of it, so it's really comfortable to walk around on. It doesn't absorb UV light. And it's woven in a manner that allows water, as people drip on it, to actually run out and scurry to the edge and then get out from underneath itself. So the mats drain well, which, unlike carpet holds water, holds moisture. Then it's prone to mildew, of course, and then it stays wet all day. It never dries out during the day when you're at the lake. So that's a really nice upgrade for this boat. And it's a cost-effective way to make sure that the flooring stays elegant yet very functional and cool to the touch. And with that padded backing, walking around on it barefooted is just a dream. So So here I am, I've boarded the back side of the boat. I'm standing on the swim platform extension. This is an upgrade from the standard integrated platform. So you'll see here where the extended platform starts right here, and then this is the integrated platform. So this is standard, of course. It's built into the tooling of the top cap of the boat. It's an engineered part of the boat. And then on the back side, we've added this swim platform extension as an option. And that's really nice because that covers the drive unit. So where I'm standing now, there's actually a stern drive system here, and you can see that we are well over that. And so as the kids jump off, even if they jump straight off the back of the boat, they're well past where the propeller would be. So there's no danger. There's a lot of peace of mind in that. For you moms and dads out there, keep that in mind. Also, you'll notice the ladder, the boarding ladder. It's a fold down style telescopic stainless steel three-step ladder. And when it folds down, it actually deploys and it ends up being right at 42 inches long. And that gets you about 2.5 feet of underwater depth. So that's perfect for getting young kids and older people out of the water with ease. You'll notice that we have the molded grip handle here on the ladder. Glastron goes to the, takes the extra cost in to upgrade that ladder. So really nice ladder. Got a grab handle as you start to make your way up into the boat. So you have something that you can actually hold on to and grab a hold of as you come up. And that really just helps to get you the rest of the way up into the boat. And then once you're up on the back side of the platform, then you can, by choice, either flip this walkthrough hinged sun lounge piece up or step over it. We really like to fold this up. Our family does, and that allows the kiddos to kind of come and go as they will through this walkway in the back. So that's a really nice feature. Keeps people off of your upholstery, keeps them from jumping on the upholstery and then down and kind of over into the boat. And as opposed to doing that, just gives them a real nice way to go in and out of the boat. Just kind of like what you would do in your home. So here I've boarded the boat and I'm inside the cockpit now. This is where all the magic takes place, if you will. Let me first start off by showing you this cushion actually comes out. So I've pulled this cushion out. And the reason I wanted to do that is I wanted to show you that Glastron's really thought ahead on how you come in and out of your boat and how to eliminate stepping on your upholstery entirely. So you can see now we can come in the boat, step down here, and then we've made our way into the cockpit easily. Underneath here, we have a hinged lid made out of starboard. That's a composite material. There's no wood in this boat. So then we get good storage access. We can put our bumpers and ropes and covers, life jackets and so forth in there. Tucked away here in this little niche, we've got a nice stainless steel cup holder. All this stainless steel that I'm going to show you is going to be a part of that XL package again. But you can see how nicely upholstered this is. It's really well padded. It's thick. It's just soft to the touch. This is as close as you can get to leather, folks, in a boat. Just do a really, really marvelous job on this upholstery. And I'm a huge fan of this color scheme. It's, again, timeless. It's classy, sophisticated looking, and does a good job of staying cool in the summer sun, but just really gives you something impressive to talk about with friends that are on the boat. Now I've taken the center cushion off, and you can see some great storage underneath here again. Bumpers, ropes, life jackets, groceries that you brought on board, backpacks, towel bags. Let me pull this seat over here. And this one's gonna really impress you. I'm gonna extend these legs down here. I was just getting my hands on these two legs here. You see them? And what I did is I folded those down. And when I folded those down, they actually kind of lock into place. Okay, so there you go. And now what I've done is I've actually created a chase lounge. Now look at this. Is this ingenious or what? So you've got a bench seat across the back, okay, that spans a full width of the beam of the boat. Seating, really practically speaking, for four adults across the back. I've pulled this seat that stows away nicely. It's a very easily converted feature. And very quickly, I can take that seat cushion, slide it out, flip the two legs down, and we have a chase lounge. Marvelous. That is just amazing. I love that feature. Here again, we're tucked away with a stainless steel cup holder, nicely padded and protected and out of the wind and elements. Stainless steel grill over our coaxial speaker. That's again stainless steel, part of the XL package. Stainless steel safety handle mounted just behind the two bucket seats. Cross stitching and contrast stitching. Just a marvelous job on the stitching and the accents. And I mean, you won't find something better than a nice luxury car than what I'm showing you here. If you could see this in person,
hopefully this video does a little bit of do justice to it, but this cross stitching, accenting, and detail work, just fabulous. Got the white welting inside here to add a little contrast. As we come to the more to the midship of the boat, I'll show you, we have a map pocket over here, which is part of that XL pack. So got a place to put valuables. We call it a map pocket, but you know, with today's technology and phones and navigational devices and maps built into our smartphones, you're going to use this more like a like an onboard purse, so to speak, with some valuables that can go in there. And we move up here, we got a lockable glove box. You'll see there, it's got a key. And in here is where we have hidden our Bimini boot, for one, and then also our stereo. So this is where we have our Sony stereo hidden away. We've got a nice little 12-volt plug here off to the side, so we can charge our phones or our iPods. Then we've got an MP3 aux input, so that's where we can actually patch in whatever music device we've carried on board into the small 3.5 millimeter plug, and we can play our music from that device, or we can carry a thumb drive or a memory stick, and it plugs in USB, and then we can actually just have that stay on the boat all the time and have boat music every time we get on the boat. Move over here to the captain's chair, the helmsman chair. Look at that flip up bucket. That comes in real handy. Mama likes that. She can sit up a little taller, see over the windshield, gives her a good line of sight. I'll just show you the difference here. Here I am sitting in the seat, looking straight out the window, out the windshield. And then let me raise it up, get about 4.5 inches of vertical rise. Now I'm looking over the windshield. So if somebody was sitting right here in front of me, up here in this bow seat, I can see over this person and over their head, and I still have line of sight with the horizon. So that's important. That's a really nice feature. You'll notice the multifunction gauges. They're analog gauges with red needles, so they're easy to read. We've got the speedometer on the top. We've got a voltmeter on the left, fuel gauge on the right. They light up at night, and they're really cool looking. It's a deep dish style, 60s muscle car style deep dish, three-way multifunction gauge. And then we've got another one on the other side. On the right hand side, we get our tachometer, bottom left temperature, bottom right engine oil pressure, again lit up. It's got this really nice stainless steel applique that goes around it. It's just really fabulous looking. Our trim gauge here, because the boat's equipped with a XL package, it has a depth sounder with built-in air and water temperature. We have old style, what I like to call old style 70s, 80s styles pull knobs for our control switches. Really cool, nostalgic look. It's got billet drilled holes in it. There's a push button horn, blower, bilge. It is equipped with an XL package, so by way of that, it comes with tilt wheel. So I can push that button and tilt this wheel up, like so. Push it again, tilt it back down, so we can customize the steering wheel angle for each driver. It is a power steered, of course. It's powered with a Volvo Penta V8 engine. It's a 350 Chevrolet. I don't think I have to tell you say much about that. We're all familiar with the 350 Chevrolet engine. Let me pop the hatch here, and I'll just show you what that looks like. Boom, there it is. There's the beast. Catalyzed, multi-port, fuel injection, freshwater cooled, Volvo Penta V8 225, 350 cubic inches or 5.7 liters of torque and raw power. Go to our ski locker here. We have the canvas stowed away. This boat's outfitted with bow and cockpit canvas. You'll see here, we got a nice ski locker, goes all the way up to the front. There we go. Here's a good picture of that expanded foam back I was trying to tell you about on this seagrass. And just think of it kind of like a neoprene pillow. It's got that kind of a effect to it. Really nice cushiony feel. Soft and smooth. I mean, just a really, really neat flooring product. Moving to the front, stainless steel handrail, stainless steel speaker covers, stainless steel handrail. Again, placed right where it should be, so when you're seated here, you can reach right over there and grab onto that thing and you're safe. Great for kids. Moms like that. Stainless steel cup holders.
Of course, they have storage under each seat. Anchor locker. And there's a look at the Bimini top. And the overall cockpit layout. Neat boat. Could go on and on, but we're approaching a record here on a 15-minute video. We usually like to keep these walk-around videos to about 5 minutes. I've kind of broke the barrier on that at this point. But there was a lot to talk about on this 2015 Glastron GT205. So many details, so well thought out, so functional, elegant, yet sporty on the outside. Got that classic Glastron spear. It's a SSV gel coat scheme, so we've got a navy blue bottom, tapers to the back, and then it comes back up on top. We have a navy blue stripe, and then all that front area is white, and it just lengthens the boat out, makes it look sporty and sleek. What a beast. Real excited about this boat, real excited about the cashmere interior. Hope you enjoyed the video. It's sitting on a color match trailer. It's gonna tow right down the highway, right behind your vehicle, the swing tongue. You can get in your garage, no worries there. Call me, my name's Martin. Call Eric, our sales manager, 512-263-2811. Visit AustinBoats.com for more information. We're a family-owned 40-year-old dealership. We're AAA plus rated, and we'll take great care of you. Our service department is second to none. Thanks for spending your time watching this video. I hope it was helpful, answered some questions for you. Give us a shout, we'll answer any other questions you got and go through more of the details with you. 512-263-2811. Again, Martin Boyer with Austin Boats and Motors, by the lake where you need us since 1974.